cover crops for the winter garden really make a lot of sense. Many of our winter garden vegetables don't require as much space as the space-hogging okra and tomatoes and corn of the summer, so you may not need as much of your garden space, or you may just want to take a break from gardening for a while, or you might want to confine your garden to a smaller area so you're not using as much of water, but don't let that garden just sit empty. Cover crops can help improve your soil, control weeds, prevent erosion, and they can even help with soil pests. So worms and beneficial soil organisms will really thrive in the root zone of cover crops. Now, cover crops are called green manure often because they add nitrogen to the soil, especially the leguminous cover crops. They grow in really thick, so they suppress chickweed, henbit, and other cool season weeds that can really be prolific in their seeding. You want to get your cover crops planted several weeks before the first frost date to get them established well before the cold sets in. You don't really need to fertilize cover crops. Just remove your crops that you've had for the summer, loosen the soil a bit, and plant the seeds. Now, birds may eat a lot of these cover crop seeds, so you may want to use row cover to protect them to get them germinated before you uncover. Now, root knot nematodes can be controlled with a cover crop of Elbon or cereal rye. This is not annual rye. It actually grows much taller than annual rye, but you don't want to let this go to seed, otherwise you'll be picking out annual rye for a long time. Annual rye gets pretty tall. It'll grow 30 to 36 inches, and you can cut it to the ground several times during the growing season and use those cuttings of the rye grass for a very rich nitrogen compost ingredient to mix with your fall leaves, so you'll have plenty of compost to go into the spring garden when you're growing the Elbon rye as a nitrogen source. The roots of the rye trap nematodes and they kill them. Other crops that are good for nematode control include mustard and marigolds. Other cover crops you might want to try are crimson clover, which is a medicinal. The flowers are used for teas, and bees love it. It's a very high nitrogen cover crop and really beautiful, too. Vetch is also a great cover crop and good for beneficial insects attracting, too. But you may need to inoculate that with rhizobium bacteria to get good germination. Now, cover crops will need a little bit of water to get started. In fact, I like to wet the seed bed down very well before I put the seeds in. Some of them will need a little bit of cover of soil over them, but give them a light watering every day to get them germinated, and they'll take off really well for you. And on the website, I'll have seeding rates of the cover crops, so check out klru.org. You can cut down the tops of these cover crops in the spring and actually just leave the roots in the soil. You can turn them in, but you could also just dig holes for your tomatoes, your peppers, and other plants right into the cover crops and leave the roots there. The roots will retain moisture, increase soil life, and you'll have a much better garden when you're using cover crops over winter. For Backyard Basics, I'm Trisha Shirey.